Good morning, student. In this video, we will see the second article of unit number 4. The name of the article is Performance Metrics for Parallel System. In the last video, we started our unit number 4, that is Analytical Modeling of Parallel Program. In the last video, we have seen sources of overhead in parallel programs. Dear students, basically inter-process communication, that is inter-process interaction, idling and excess computation are the three main sources of overhead in parallel programs. Inter-process interaction, that is any non-trivial program requires its processing elements to interact and communicate data. Example, intermediate result, the time spent in communicating data between processing element is usually the most significant source of parallel processing overhead. So it is a common task that the processes are communicating with each other in order to execute their operations. Sometimes the process remains ideal. Processing elements in parallel system may become ideal due to many reasons such as load imbalance, synchronization, and presence of serial components in the programs. In many parallel applications, for example, when the task generation is dynamic, it is impossible or at least difficult to predict the size of subtask assigned to various processing elements. Hence, the problem cannot be subdivided statically among the processing elements while maintaining the uniform workload. So that time the process remains ideal, that is imbalanced load imbalancing. Now another issue, that excess computation, the fastest known sequential algorithm for problem may be difficult or impossible to parallelize, forcing us to use the parallel algorithm based on poor but easily parallelizable, that is one with higher degree of concurrency, sequential algorithm. The difference in computation performed by parallel programs and the best serial program is the excess computation overhead incurred by parallel programs. So these are the three main sources of overhead in parallel programs. Now, performance metrics of parallel system. This is the second article of this unit number 4. It is important to study the performance of parallel programs with the view of determining best algorithm. Evaluating hardware platform and examining the benefits from parallelism, the number of metrics have been used based on desired outcomes of performance analysis. Now, students, see, serial runtime of program is the time elapsed between beginning and end of its execution on sequential computer. The parallel runtime is the time that elapsed from the moment the first processor starts to the moment the last processor finishes its execution. We denote the serial time or serial runtime and serial runtime by TS and parallel runtime by TP. So now let's see, there is a execution time. So a serial runtime of a program is the time elapsed between beginning and the end of its execution, as shown here on a serial computer. The parallel runtime is the time that elapsed from moment the parallel computation start to the moment the last processing element finished its execution. That is, TS is nothing but the serial time and TP is nothing but the parallel runtime. So this is the execution time. Now, total parallel overhead. The overhead incurred by the parallel programs are encapsulated into single expression referred to as overhead function. We define overhead function or total overhead of the parallel system as the total time collectively spent by all processing elements over the above that required by the fastest known sequential algorithm for solving the same problem on single processing element. We denote the override function of a parallel system by symbol TO. The total time spent in solving the problem summed over all processing element is PTP into TS. That is, TS units of its time are spent performing useful work, and the remainder is override. Therefore, the override function TO is given by TO equal to PTS minus TS. So let T all be the total time collectively spent by all processing element, and TS is a serial time. Observe that T all minus TS is the total time spent by all processor combined in non-useful work. This is called total override. The total time collectively spent by all processing element T all equal to PTP. P is the number of processor. The override function TO is therefore given by, the override function is given by TO equal to PTP minus TS. Okay, PTP minus TS. Okay, here it is not shown, but the total overhead is given by TO equal to PTP minus TS. PTP is what? PTP is the total time collectively spent by all processing element. P is the number of processor, and TS is the serial time. So if I minus PTP minus TS, I will get the total overhead. Now here, what is the benefits from parallelism? What is the benefit from parallelism? So the answer is speed up. When evaluating the parallel system, we are often interested in knowing how much performance gain is achieved by parallelizing a given application over the sequential implementation. Speed up is the measure that captures the relative benefit of solving the problem in parallel. It is defined as the ratio of the time taken to solve the problem on a single processing element to the time required to solve the same problem on parallel computer with P identical processing element. We denote the speed up by the symbol capital S. So see here, speed up is the ratio of the time taken to solve the problem on single processor to the time required to solve the same problem on parallel computers with P identical processing element. It is denoted by capital S. Now, performance matrix example. See here, consider one example of adding n numbers using n processing element. So consider the problem of adding n numbers by using n processing element. Initially, each processing element is assigned one of the number to be added, and at the end of the computation, one of the processing element stores the sum of all numbers. Assuming that n is the power of 2, we can perform this operation in log n step by propagating the partial sum up a logical binary tree of processing element. So if n is the power of 2, we can perform this operation in log n by propagating the partial sum of the logical binary tree of the processor, as shown in this figure. See here. So figure shows the procedure for n is equal to 16 processing element, okay, or 16 numbers. The processing elements are labeled from 0 to 15. Similarly, the 16 numbers to be added are labeled from 0 to 15. The sum of the numbers with consecutive labels from I to J is denoted by summation I to J. Each step shown in this figure consists of one addition and communication of single word. So we are adding and we are communicating with the neighbor. The addition can be performed in some constant time, say TC. And the communication of the single word can be performed in time TS plus TW. So therefore, the addition and the communication operation takes the constant amount of time, that is TP equal to big O log N. Since the problem can be solved in big O of N time on single processing elements, its speed up is capital S is equal to big O N by log N. So this figure shows the computing the global sum of 16 partial sum using 16 processing element. Summation I is equal to J denote the sum of the numbers with consecutive labels from I to J. So here you can see in if an addition take the constant time say TC and the communication of a single word takes TS plus TW, we have the parallel time TP equal to big O log N. We know that TS equal to big O log N, sorry, big O N. Speed up can be given. What is the speed up? Speed up is the ratio of the time taken to solve the problem on a single processing element to the time taken to solve the same problem on parallel computer with P identical processing element. So now S is equal to big O N by log N. That is the speed up of this problem. Okay. So for given problem, more than one sequential algorithm may be available, but all of them may not be equally suitable for parallelization. So this is the example of adding N numbers on N processing element. Now, see here, performance matrix speed up. For given problem, there might be many serial algorithms available. These algorithm may have different asymptotic runtime and may be parallelized to different degrees. So for the purpose of computing speed up, we always consider the base sequential program as the baseline. Okay, so this is very important. Every time we need to consider the base sequential program as a baseline for calculating the speed up. Now, another example of speed up or performance metrics is available, and that example is nothing but sorting. So consider the problem of bubble sort. Okay, so consider the problem of parallelizing the bubble sort. Assume that a serial version of the bubble sort of 10 raised to 5 records takes 150 seconds, and the serial quick sort can sort the same list in 30 seconds. If the parallel version of a bubble sort, also called odd even sort, takes 40 seconds on 4 processing element, it would appear that the parallel odd even sort algorithm result in speed up of 150 by 40 or 3.75. However, this conclusion is misleading, as in reality the parallel algorithm result in speed up of 30 by 40, that is 0.75, with respect to the base serial algorithm. Okay, here now we are considering the another problem of speed up. Consider the problem of parallel bubble sort. A serial time for bubble sort is 150 seconds, and the parallel time for odd even sort, efficient parallelizations of bubble sort, is 40 seconds. So speed up can be 3.75, but in reality a fair assessment of the system can be done. So what if the serial quick sort only take 30 seconds, and in this case the speed up is 30 by 40, so 0.75. so this is a more realistic assessment of the system. Okay, so speed up can be as low as 0. The parallel program never terminates. Theoretically, speed up can never exceeds the number of processing element P. If the base sequential algorithm takes TS units of time to solve the given problem on a single processing element, then the speed up of P can be obtained on P processing element if none of the processing element spends more than time TS by P. So that's why speed up can be as low as 0. Speed up in theory should upper bounded by P. After all, we can only expect a p-fold speed up if we use time as many resources. Okay, a speed up greater than P is possible only if each processing element spends less time TS by P solving the problem. In this case, a single processor could be time slided to achieve the faster serial program, which contradicts our assumption of fastest serial program as the basis for speed up. Okay, so now you can see here a performance matrix, super linear speed up. So what is a super linear speed up? Consider an algorithm for exploring the leaf nodes of an unstructured tree. Each leaf has a label associated with it, and the objective is to find a node with specified label. In this case, capital S. Such computations are often used to solve the combinational problem, where the label S could imply the solution of the problem. As shown in this figure, okay, it shows a tree. The solution node is the rightmost leaf in the tree. A serial formulation of this problem based on the depth first tree traverser explores the entire tree, that is all 14 nodes. If it takes time TC to visit a node, the time for this traversal is 14 TC. Now consider the parallel formulation in which the left subtree is explored by processing element 0 and the right subtree by processing element 1. If both processing elements explore the tree at the same speed, the parallel formulation explores only the shaded nodes before the solution is found. Notice that the total work done by the parallel algorithm is only 9 node expansion, that is 9 TC. Corresponding parallel time, assuming the root node expansion is serial, is 5 TC. One root node expansion followed by 4 node expansion by each processing element. The speed up of these two processor execution is therefore 14 TC by 5 TC or 2.8. The cause of this superlinearity is that the work performed by parallel and serial algorithm is different. Indeed, if the two processor algorithm was implemented as two processor on the same processing element, the algorithmic superlinearity will disappear for this problem instance. Note that when exploratory decomposition is used, the relative amount of work performed by serial and parallel algorithm is depends upon the location of the solution. And it is often not possible to find the serial algorithm that is optimal for all instance. Such effects are further discussed in these chapters. So as shown in this figure, one reason for superlinearity is the parallel version does less work than corresponding serial algorithm. Okay, searching an unstructured tree for a node with label S on two processing element using depth first traversal, the two processor version with processor 0 searching the left subtree and processor 1 searching the right subtree expands only the shaded nodes before the solution found. The corresponding serial formulation expands the entire tree. It is clear that the serial algorithm does more work than the parallel algorithm. Okay, so resource based superlinearity. The higher aggregate cache or memory bandwidth can result in better cache hit ratio and therefore superlinearity. For example, a processor with 64 kilobyte or KB of cache yield 80% hit ratio if two processors are used. Since the problem size per processor is smaller, the hit ratio goes up to 90%. On the remaining 10% access, 8% come from local memory and 2% come from remote memory. If DRAM access time is 100 nanoseconds, cache access time is 2 nanoseconds, and the remote memory access time is 400 nanoseconds, this corresponds to speed up of 2.43. Okay. Now the next is efficiency. What is the efficiency? Performance matrix efficiency. So we have seen the speed up. Speed up is the total time taken by the serial computer to, it is the ratio of total time taken by the serial machines to solve the same problem on parallel machines Okay, that is the speed up. So TS by TP is the speed up. Now, what is efficiency? Only an ideal parallel system containing P processing element can deliver the speed up equal to P. In practice, ideal behavior is not achieved because while executing the parallel algorithm, the processing element cannot devote 100% of their time to the computation of algorithm. As shown in the previous example, the part of the time required for processing element to compute the sum of n numbers is spent idling and communicating in real system. Efficiency is the measure of the fraction of time for which the processing element is usually employed. And how it is defined? It is defined as the ratio of the speed up to the number of processing element. So E is equal to S by P. Because efficiency is the measure of the fraction of time for which the processing element is usually deployed. And it is defined as ratio of speed up to the number of processing element. In an ideal parallel system, speed up is equal to P and efficiency is equal to 1. In practice, speed up is less than P and efficiency is between 0 and 1. Depending on the effectiveness with which the processing elements are utilized, we denote the efficiency by the symbol E, and mathematically it is given E is equal to S by P. So following the bounds on speed up, efficiency can be as low as 0 and as high as 1. Okay. Now, efficiency example. The speed up of adding n numbers on n processing element is given by S is equal to n by log P. So now we know the efficiency. So efficiency is nothing but the S by P. So substituting the value of S, we get efficiency as big O n log n by n. That is equal to big O 1 by log n. That is the efficiency of adding n numbers on n processing element. Okay, so now another example, that is parallel time speed up and efficiency example. So this example we will see in the next video. So we will stop here, because in this video we have seen two very important characteristics of parallel performance matrix, that is speed up and second one is efficiency. We also discuss about the super linear speed up. So this much is sufficient for this video. In the next video, we will start this article, parallel time speed up and efficiency example. So till then, thank you very much. Good day.